In this example, we want to find the domain and range of f of x equals x minus 2 over 2 minus x. So let's start with a brief review of the definitions of domain and range. We can think of the domain as the set of all allowable inputs into the function. These are oftentimes associated with the x values, and the range you can think of as the set of all outputs, oftentimes associated with the y values. That's a pretty simplistic definition of domain and range, but it does the trick for most functions on the real numbers for now. So let's work at finding the domain here. You may notice that the numerator and the denominator in this function are very similar, and in fact, we can simplify this function here. So let's write this as f of x equals, okay, let's factor out a negative in the denominator. Look at this, negative. This becomes, that flips the signs of everything left behind, so we can just write this as x minus 2 again, right? These now cancel, and we have negative 1. So the question might be, is the domain then all real numbers? The answer would be no, it's not. You always want to take the domain before simplifying. And a good way to approach domain in a function like this is to find the x values that are not allowed. Right, and we know one thing is for sure, that we can't have 0 in the denominator. So here I'm just going to say, all right, this denominator cannot equal 0. Right, so we have 2 minus x does not equal 0. Solve that, that gives us 2 does not equal x. So the domain is going to be everything except for that point. Right, so here's our domain. There's a couple ways to write this. The most compact way would be like this, x such that x does not equal 2. That's fine, right? That's a fine answer. Sometimes you might want to write it as something a little more complicated. It's the same approach, but you could write this as negative infinity up to 2. You union across it, start over again, 2 to infinity, right? But we'll just stick with x such that x is not equal 2. The range is the set of y values. Well, no matter what you plug in for x, you only get one y value out. It's negative 1 no matter what goes in for x. So the range is going to be a single point, negative 1. There we go.